colon cancers usually occur when you're past 40 to 50.
So 50 years old, that's why I got mine done at 49 years old.
But you're right, increasingly we are finding younger people with colon cancers as well.
Welcome to We Need to Talk About This, and today we have with us Dr. Look, and he is a gastrointestinal surgeon. And today we're going to be talking about colorectal cancer.
Here's the thing, colorectal cancer is the number one cancer amongst men, as we learned earlier, the second most common amongst women. Those are incredible numbers, and I never knew that it affected so many people. So how do we then test for these things easily?
One of the important things to do is to screen for colorectal cancer. And the precursors of colorectal cancer, which are these little colorectal polyps that develop way before the cancer develops.
Is that what we're seeing here?
Yeah, that little polyps that if they are left alone, they can grow and undergo cancer change to become cancer. And this process takes about 5 to 10 years. In other words, there's a very good window of opportunity where we can remove these polyps and prevent colorectal cancer. In fact, colorectal cancer is one of the most preventable cancers.
I just got my tests done. I had the scope, I had the colonoscopy, and removed a few polyps. And he said, you know, if you want to be super safe, come back in 3 years, but 4 years at least. And that seems easy enough to me.
Yes, it is. It's a very safe and comfortable procedure. There are two ways we can screen for colorectal cancer.
Yeah.
The direct way, which is a direct visualization of the entire colonoscopy, can also do an indirect testing, what we call the poop test. What we are testing for is the indirect presence of human blood.
I have never seen anyone handle poop so comfortably in my life.
Okay, so this is Play-Doh representing poop here. And so I'll put this here. What do we do?
So detection of a human blood in the stool samples is an indication that something is wrong in the colon, either the presence of a cancer or a large polyp. So this is what we call the FIT test, which is the Faecal Immunochemical Test. The first thing is to get your hands on the test kit.
Okay.
You can either walk to the doctor's office and you get one of these, what we call the pooper scooper.
Who comes up with these names? Pooper scooper, I love it.
Basically, all you need to do is get a piece of toilet paper.
Okay.
As you pass the stools, try to catch it. Okay, without any pee, without touching any water.
I guess that's doable. If you can wipe, you can do that, right?
Yes. Yeah.
But I'm curious, why does it need to be dry in that case?
Because it will interfere with the...
It'll contaminate the piece, right? Yeah, if you get any liquid on this, it might flush out the blood or whatever was in there.
Dr. Mike is on fire.
Hello.
On fire.
So you collect the specimen, just scoop a little bit into the bottle and bring it back to the office. The second test kit, which is a free test kit that you can get from the Singapore Cancer Society. You go online and check out where you can pick up these test kits at a lot of the major pharmacies. So you bring this home and just poke it into the stools a couple of times, different places.
Oh,
I love that he's treating it like he actually has a real piece of dew here. Yeah. He's using the paper to touch it, and I had his hand in my hands.
Okay, collect some stools, put it in.
That's
like the ARC.
You don't need like a big chunk of it.
You don't need a big chunk of it.
Oh, okay.
Check it out. Wrap it in the absorbent paper, put it in the plastic bag. Put your name and details together with the whole thing and mail it back to the Singapore Cancer Society. Okay, the third test kit you can get is something you can buy online.
Okay.
Which is almost like an ART sort of a test kit where you do everything yourself and you get a positive or negative directly at home.
Okay. I see.
Collect the poop, keep this upright.
It's very similar to what you did earlier.
Yeah.
As well. Okay, very similar.
Collect the stools and a couple of passes, put it back in. Shake it, mix it, and open this one, not the green one.
Yeah. So this looks exactly like an ART kit, right? Now that we're more familiar with that.
This is the test well. Yeah. Put a couple of drops into the test well.
Yeah, I guess we all are experts at this point, right?
So familiar with this.
You got your two lines that will come up.
But clearly we're going to get like an invalid result here.
Yeah, because this is Play-Doh. If this Play-Doh has cancer, that'd be interesting.
That would be confusing,
Okay, so this,
this is a
kit that you do entirely on your own. So you can do it in the privacy of your own home.
Okay.
So here's the thing, like the moment you get, say, a positive result, I mean, obviously you're going to feel a little bit of panic. What's the first thing you should do? Just make an appointment straight away?
The first thing you should do is not panic.
Okay. Stay calm.
A lot of times, a positive result could be due to a presence of blood in the stools from a variety of problems in the gut.
Hemorrhoids even, right? Yeah.
Hemorrhoids. You could have inflammation in the colon, polyps in the colon, or even cancer, or even hemorrhoids. So don't panic if you have a positive result, but you must get yourself checked up if you have positive result. Do not repeat the test and hope for a negative result. Because that's the wrong thing to do.
But he's like reading our minds. He's like, don't do, I know what you're going to do.
But I guess you can feel comfortable because the fact that you're doing this means you're probably going to catch it early, especially if you do it every so often.
Do you think people don't test themselves enough when it comes to this, especially because it's so easily done at home?
I think the awareness for screening is quite low in Singapore. Mm. That's why I think we need a lot of education so that people do not be afraid of coming for colonoscopies or even doing a simple poop test.
But is there a certain age group that
there is, because colon cancers usually occur when you're past 40 to 50. Mm. So the recommended age of testing is 50 when you should start doing this. And if you're doing the poop test, you should do it every year.
So 50 years old, that's why I got mine done at 49 years old.
But you're right. Increasingly, we are finding younger people with colon cancers as well. So in America, they're starting to bring down the age of screening to 45.
And like you mentioned earlier, it could be due to diet and stuff like that. Or is diet the first thing that we should adjust if, we're concerned about this?
Variety of reasons why colon cancer occur. Diet is one of them. Intake of a lot of red meat, processed meat, especially lack of fiber in the diet.
Vegetables, man, your legumes, your beans, your vegetables. And my colon was not inflamed. It was in great shape. And I do eat a ton of vegetables and not as much meat. So
yeah, fantastic. You're in good shape.
I attribute it to that.
Your poop is fine. Your poop is good, right? Thank you so much, doctor, for sharing this with us.
My pleasure.
It is definitely important to raise more awareness about testing out there as well. So I think this was super informative.
And thank you guys for watching. We need to talk about this. We'll see you.
If you would like more health tips, be sure to catch our main show, Let's Talk About Health, on MeWatch and Channel 5.